such a cool angle. Can't get you out of my
What's going on, everybody? Dragas here, and welcome back to episode 2 of Planet Coaster. Now, if you missed the first episode, go watch it, because this game is just so damn cool. But yeah, we started building our park here. We got our wonderful little Ferris wheel, we got our double-looped roller coaster, we got the Sky Screamer, or whatever the hell it's called, and of course, our beautiful little tree. Now, I was going to go into the nitty-gritty today of doing a lot of decorations and whatnot, the kind of stuff that makes just a park a little bit more pretty, which is what we're definitely going to do in the near future. But I got a good idea now. I'm seeing this tree and I'm thinking, roller coasters, what can I do with it? So I think it would be fun to put a huge corkscrew all the way down this tree, as well as maybe put something on top here. Like, this tree is absolutely bonkers looking. This tree is the attraction of this park after all, so I gotta assume a ride going around this tree, probably a smart idea. So yeah, I know the last thing we ended off with the first episode was building this roller coaster, and it's kind of weird to build another one right away, but that's exactly what I want to do right now. So we're going to go into another one, and let's get into it. By the way, if you did purchase the alpha of this game and you don't know why your roller coaster tab isn't open, as you can see it says coming soon, you actually have to opt into it. So you go into the little search function here, and then type in under construction. One word, that's all you do, and it should automatically open up. I mean, nothing shows up here, but as you can see, the tab actually opens up, and then here you have access to your two roller coasters. So we did a box spline track before. Let's try out the arrows track. Coaster track with the dead drop, equalizer, gasm, and phoenix cars. So yeah, this is a totally different track type here. Where do I want to put the starting of this, though? Because if I put it over here, we're getting close to the wall, and that's going to be a pain in the ass to build this thing. I think we're going to kind of do it down here. So I think for this roller coaster, we're actually going to make a bigger one as well, which means we can add multiple stations here, therefore having multiple carts. At least I think that's how it works. I'm hoping it is, because I'm going to try that out. And also, this one, we started out with a chain track all the way up. I kind of want to try a booster track, like, way out here, up to a big hill or something. Okay, so I put a bunch of boosted tracks on this, so hopefully it gets enough speed to do a decent hill here. So yeah, we're just gonna go back to the basic tracks now, lift this sucker up, and start going high. Actually, I wonder how high we can go. Oh man, you can go real high in this game, guys. It's looking like, holy shit, I don't know if there's a limit. Okay, well that's gotta be high enough for me for right now. That's gonna be one scary ride. I hope I have enough boosted track to get up here. The only thing I don't like about this roller coaster builder so far, I don't know if it's just these types of roller coasters, but this is the steepest drop I can do. There's no, like, 90-degree drops. I've been trying to play with this to see if this changes anything, and it looks like it does, but it doesn't really allow me to go any steeper, depending on the angle that I put this at. So, obviously, 90 degrees being the deepest angle, we're just going to do that, and let's start banking this thing if we can. Why is it not letting me bank it? Oh, there we go. Oh, this is for... Okay, so I know what this is for then. This is if you want to do exact angles. I'm going to put it at 0, and then I can do it however I want. So that makes sense. But yeah, like I said, that's as steep as you can go for a drop-off. So I don't know. Just one little complaint. Not too bad, though. Okay, this is coming together real nicely here. I'm going to start trying to even this thing out. Let's actually, yeah, slow down the drop a little bit here. You can see this is going to be really crazy. And there we go. We have pretty much reached ground level for right now. I mean, look at this drop. That would be the coolest coaster ever. Now, I'm hoping we have enough speed to actually do the corkscrew right now over here. So let's start turning it that way. There we go. This is looking freaking grand right now. I should probably actually, let's control Z this just in case. I want to bank these turns pretty hard so I don't have anything falling off of them. There we go. Something like that should be good. Nice and banked. And let's straighten it out and go right over to that tree. Actually, you know what? We're going to do some more boosted tracks to get to this tree. I mean, this thing's going to be going so fast. Okay, boosted tracks are done. Let's start lifting this up. Now, I don't actually know if there's any easy way to do a corkscrew, so my corkscrew might look a little ugly here, but I'm going to do my best. Okay, something like that should be good. Let's start banking it towards the tree so they can all look at the tree. There we go. Build that and start turning it. Aw, this game just works so good. It's so nice to have an actual 3D amusement park game that can actually be easily built. Like, look at this. I'm having no problems at all. I'm building this thing so damn quickly. I am so passionate about this game already. And look at that. We're going right through the tree here. This is just fan-freaking-tastic. I am so pumped. All right, let's lift it up a little bit. There we go. And let's add some more to this. Look at it. It's totally fine. This is great. And up the tree we go. You know what? I can almost automate this whole process. That's the great thing about it. Just fine-tune, tuning, and then, like, see, it's like, it's no problem at all. Okay, I'm trying something here, ladies and gentlemen. I'm trying to get through the tree here and, like, go so damn close to the branches that people will probably freak out. This is looking actually really good right now. I don't think this is going to hit their heads or anything. I think they'll be totally fine. So let's build that. Oh, can I not build that? Oh, maybe I can't build through here. No fun. I wanted to do that. Hold on. Maybe if I up it a little bit more. You know what? Let's back up and make this a little smaller. That way I can fine-tune it a bit more. I'm going to do this, damn it. Oh, yes. This is even better. I found a better hole, guys. Oh, shit. Okay, why is it churning, though? It's, like, randomly churning from time to time. I don't want it to go that way. I want it to go right through the freaking tree. You know what? Let's actually try and corkscrew it if we can. Oh, this is going to be... God damn it, it's not letting me do it again. There's got to be something in the way here. Maybe if I turn it a little bit. Is that good? No. Okay. Oh, is that good? Is that good? Oh, shit. Okay. I have to get the thing to the ground. That is my biggest problem. Oh, shit. I can't even see. All right. We obviously got to drop this now. Man, I think we're going to hit our... Yeah, we're definitely going to hit our heads if we do this. Okay, I got to redo this. Okay, so clearly it doesn't want me going through this middle hole. Like, I can go up really high and it allows it, but I don't know why. If I go down really low, it allows it as well, but then I'm going into the friggin' tree. And I got to assume that's not a good thing. So we're going to actually back up to here. And what if I go around to this side a little bit and bank it? I wish it wasn't nighttime so you guys could see better. I wouldn't, and so could I could see better as well. But I think this might be okay if we can somehow get this to... Oh, maybe? Maybe, is that good? No, shit! See, this one beam! That's the fucking problem. I almost got it, it's just there's one beam in the way. Okay, I have given up with that, and we're going back to the original plan of going through this slightly easier hole. There's gotta be one hole I can get through. As long as I can get through one branch, I'm happy. Oh, there we go! Is that good? Is this... Oh, shit, what the fuck's wrong now? Are all these attached to the ground? It looks like they are, yet it's still not even allowing me to do it because I don't know why. That looks totally fine to me. Okay, I'm starting to think this is actually impossible. Like, even when it's as perfect, if I go through a branch, it doesn't like it. So, we're just going to have to revert back to going below. I hate doing that, but you know what? Maybe next time we'll figure it out. So, that's good enough for right now. Let's even this out a little bit here. I don't even know where I'm going right now. Actually, you know what? What if I go... Ooh, I'm liking this. If I go under the road a little bit, we want to invert it this way. Let's go right friggin' sideways, actually. Something like that. And then start bringing it this way real hard. Go down lower and just keep going right under. Yes, perfect. That's exactly what I wanted to do. And then let's turn this back and start going actually above this. Actually, you know what? I'm going to stick with this. And we're just going to... build all the way. You know what? I'm going to do a weird loop here, I think. That's what I want to do. I'm hoping... Oh, man. This is going to be dangerous, though. I know there's going to be so many problems with this roller coaster. Most ghetto loop ever. But it's going to work, so I don't even care. All right, let's slow this down a little bit. Something like that. Let me see the angle here. I don't want to be upside down for this long, so let's start turning it this way. And let's even it out. Okay, there we go. And we have landed back to the ground. Everything looks fantastic. I mean, look at that. I have put a whole roller coaster around this tree. I'm gonna be honest here, probably not the safest place to put a support beam on fucking leaps. Okay, and now it's just a quick run back to the front entrance. And we should be good to try this thing out and see how it is. There we go, that should be good, and we gotta start braking, so we wanna brake right now, and let's try and straighten this. Oh, you can't even turn brakes either? This is slightly annoying. Okay, so we wanna drop this down to something that I can fine-tune with. That looks good. Let's obviously even this out a bit, and let's start changing this track. There we go, and there we go. Now, I gotta actually add brakes after this to actually brake these things. Okay, so there we go. And that should be more than enough brakes So let's put it back to normal, and this should just automatically... It automatically before... Oh, yep, there we go. You can see it automatically attaches. That's huge, because in Roller Coaster Tycoon World, it didn't do that, and it was a bitch to try and reattach it. Okay, well, here was our simple first coaster. As you can see, quite big, but nothing compared to this coaster. I mean, I love the fact that it just goes all around this tree. Okay, I got the entrance all set up. These guys are already coming. I haven't even put carts on the fucking track yet. Are you kidding me, bro? Are you kidding me? Give me a second here. Okay, so let's actually add some trains to this. So I guess the max cars we can have is 5. Let's change the train here. Let's go for Rage. I feel like that's a good train name for this. You can add 8 to that. Perfect. So there we go. We got quite a big train here. I wish I could add more trains, but I guess I can't. So maybe building this was pointless. I might need to edit that out. I don't know if it's going to get through that. But once again, we didn't test our actual ride, so let's hope for the best here, I guess, and I guess we're going to ride with them. Okay, here we go. We only got a couple on the ride here. Actually, you know what? Let's go to the seat. Actually, no. I do want to see if these guys die. I mean, that would be hilarious. And I can't really see with this camera, so we're just going to go back to cinematic. Why not? Well, clearly I don't know how boosted tracks work, because this is not being boosted right now. And these guys are stuck on the ride. Fuck. I mean, this should be boosting them. Do I have to, like, power it on or something? Because this is not working at all. Obviously, we have an issue here. I have to restart this. People are already waiting, getting all excited. Fuck, I didn't even make an exit line. Okay, so here we go. I have to actually close the ride to edit it. So remove trains. There we go. And we definitely do want to edit this track to get rid of this. Oh, shit. That's not good. I didn't want to do that. Control Z. Okay, thank God for Control Z. I did right-click, though, and that happened, so I don't really get it, but I want to get rid of this one. Let me go to this one. Okay, let me see. Right-click? Ha-ha! It worked. Oh, there's a start button here. I'm assuming, yes, this in fact starts it without opening it up, so I don't have to kill people. That's nice. Now, let's see if this boosted track works. Come on! What is going on with the boosted tracks? Oh my god, I'm getting anxiety in the game. People, please just fuck off. I'm still building the damn thing. Please don't wait for me. So my screen recorder crashed. I didn't realize, but we didn't really do too much anyways. I'm just going to explain what I did. Now, I actually edited all these tracks, and that's my one complaint with this game. It's actually really hard, as you can see, to edit tracks to make them look nice and streamlined once you have placed them. So it's kind of looking a little wonky here. But basically, I changed all the boosted tier to chain tracks. As much as I didn't want to, the boosted doesn't seem to be working for me. So we got a very small chain track hill here just to get up to the big hill, and then a chain track all the way up to the top, and then I didn't change anything else. Okay, so it wants me to place the entrance again. It must have got rid of it. Like, look at these guys. They're just fucking waiting here. All the pressure is on me. Place exit. Okay, we'll place that over there. And now we can add a train. The equalizer, we'll keep that on. Actually, I don't know if the weight difference of the trains is going to affect it. I was just going to keep this on for now, but I actually want to change this to the Rage once again. And actually, I wonder what one has the most amount of carts. Let me see. Werewolf has 9, Rage has 8, and Gasm has 8. So I guess Werewolf is the biggest one. Let's try that one then. Okay, so we added that train track. Let's start this thing out and see if it works. If it does, these people are going to have a great time. Oh. Well, I fucked up that now, didn't I? Okay, so that should be a quick fix. Let's just put chain lift on here, build that. There we go, looking good. And I think that is all that I really needed to do. All right, fix that little issue. That's looking just fantastic. And we're going to go nice and slow up until here. And now comes the big climb. I don't think I've ever seen a roller coaster quite this big. This is pretty crazy. You know what? I want to go to the front seat. There we go. Man, if I had my Oculus Rift right now and this had Rift support, that would be great. Oh my god, I wish I could just... Can I see out the side? I mean, you can't even really see my Ferris wheel. We're that high up. All right, here we go. Let's hope I don't kill myself. We're going for the drop. Yeah! Oh my god. Now, the big question is this enough speed to do this huge-ass corkscrew? I'm feeling like we're not going fast enough. Oh, God, those poles are so close to my face. Actually, I think we got lots of speed here, guys. There we go. All right, sideways. Okay, that pole definitely hit my face. And around to the ending. I can't believe that didn't fall off. That is seriously amazing. Jesus. Okay, well, oddly enough, that was a complete success. I don't know if maybe the physics aren't in this game yet, or I'm just really good at building roller coasters that are quite safe. Anyways, I guess that means we can open this up to the public and they can join us in on the fun. I actually probably should build an exit line so they can get off too. That would be smart. So let's just do that really quickly while they are actually loading up. Why is there only... I'm confused why there's no one else coming in. Is there an issue here or something? Oh, I hear him moving now, so that must be mean it's okay. Yes, there we go. We got not even a full load. I don't understand. I mean, look at the line here. Oh, this is such a cool angle. I love watching these. This is what I like so much about theme park games. Just the views you get. I mean, this is just great. Corkscrew working just fine. No one's getting their head clipped off or anything, so that's good. And it seems to be working just as planned. And to the stop. Pretty hard stop, but it seems to work just fine. So the testing worked. The first run of people worked. They seem to be quite happy with themselves. So I think this is a pretty good ride. Okay, guys. Well, another successful episode in the wonderful world of Planet Coaster. I hope you guys are enjoying this game. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And if you have any suggestions on what you want to see in the next episode, please feel free to write them down below. As always, I just want to say thank you for watching and liking. And I will see you in the next one.